The first thing I'm just going to talk very briefly is the technology vision 2035. There was one of the speakers mentioned that we should have a vision. This is a vision for the country. So I'm just going to talk very briefly on that. We had developed technology vision 2020 earlier under Dr. Kalam's leadership that was released 20 years back. This is the second one that we have come out with. Don't have time to go in details, but what we start by doing is looking at what we visualize in 2020 document and where do we stand today. We compare to horses motion and looking at various sectors, where do we stand for India galloping, India cantering, India trotting, India walking. Then a major difference between that document and this document is that that time we had looked at India as a country, this time the focus is on Indian citizens. So we talk about people of the country, we talk about their prosperity, security, identity aspects. And let me leave out these details. These are the documents are on the website. Then we said that if we close our eyes today and we open in 2035, what do you want to see? Then we have translated that into 12 prerogatives that we call here. These are 6 individual and 6 collective. For each of these, we actually identify technology at different stages, technology which is ready to deploy, technology which needs to go from lab to field, technology which needs targeted research in technology and imagination. We talked about transversal technology like ICT, for example. We've talked about countries' capabilities and constraints. And then we identified 10 grand challenges. These are the kind of thing that DARPA does, identify grand challenges which is thrown open. So DARPA says that it does not manage programs, it manages projects. In the government system in India, we manage programs, not the projects. So specific challenges are thrown. Ethernet was an outcome of that, for example. And actually, one of the first challenges I must mention is eliminating female child anemia. It's like more than 80% of women and child in India are affected by this. This is one of the grand challenges, for example. I will leave out the details. This document is being followed by 12 technology roadmaps covering all the sectors. So we have a vision document and there are 12 technology roadmaps to achieve that vision. We also keep track of technology trends across the globe. We share it. We look at analyze from impact on India. Let me leave out the other things. We are also developing security technology, security in the broader aspect. Solar photovoltaic, electric mobility, let me leave out these again. Okay, the innovation part is where I should focus a little bit. We have 3 programs which, you know, cover the innovation space, starting from patent facilitation. So we file patents on behalf of all academic institutes and government art institutes free of cost in India and abroad and maintain them. We have been doing it for 20 years. Second part is the technology refinement. This is a technology transfer program called TRIMA program. And third one is scaling up of innovations. So here we provide soft loan. Actually, one more program that we run as part of our patent center is to train women scientists who had a mid-career break into IPR-related activity. We give them training for 1 year. Through this program, actually, we have created 10% of India's patent professionals and all women. We actually give fellowship to them as well. 8th batch is just going on. Now, one of the issues was that we don't have synergy between various programs. I found that even my own programs did not have synergy. What we are trying to do is now, just two weeks back, we had a meeting of all the government innovation schemes. We brought them together on one platform to make sure that the innovator does not have to run from pillar to post. We have hundreds of programs, but nobody talks to anybody else. Within the same institute, nobody talks to each other. So what we have to do is break this barrier. And so 25th August, we had a meeting. And now we're trying to bring all the stakeholders together which support innovation so that the schemes can know, if I submit a proposal, it can go from one to another. And there could be a common portal where I could submit a proposal. So this we are working on. There was a lot of talk about MSME in the first earlier session. We have 2 programs to support MSME. One is a cluster program where we upgrade technology of MSME cluster. We used to earlier do hard intervention, but now MSME is doing. Now we only do soft intervention. The second part is that we're asked to boost export in certain areas of MSME. Other thing we're doing is that to bring advanced technology to MSME sector, for example, 3D printing to MSME sector. There's a last point here that we're saying that can we say that all the spare parts, as a policy decision, we make sure that it's going to be 3D printable so that we don't depend on foreign manufacturers to supply spares because many times the critical time needs, we don't have them. This is an important point. We were asked to look into guar gum and its export. I just said the outcome. Outcome was that we send out the raw material out of the country. At one time, we were exporting 21,000 crore worth of Guargam only, but we don't do any value addition. We looked at the patents, 80% of Guargam India exports, but if you look at the patents, out of nearly 12,000 patents, India's contribution is less than 1%. So we have the strength, but we don't do value addition, we don't do research on our strength, we work for somebody else. We have looking at this, now actually we have picked up, we are looking at all the raw materials that we send out. I have a list of 792 raw materials where India is a major manufacturer or exporter, and the list of hundreds of minerals are as well there. They themselves add up, just the guar gum one sector, there's a potential 50,000 crore rupees earning per year. Okay, 50,000 to 100,000 crore if I can do the value addition rather than sending out the raw material. ESDM sector is very important. We were also asked to look into this. What one issue that was being discussed in the earlier session was the mindset issue. Mindset issue is that our students don't learn hands-on learning. They don't look at real problems. So we have started an MSME internship program where we actually in giving incentive to students to go into a small industry. We give them money in two phases. So first phase, they go and identify problems. Second phase, if the problems they have identified and solutions they suggest is good, we support them in the second one with more money and more funds so that they can spend longer time. So this is a program that we have launched. Now we are a think tank, so we cannot scale it up. What we need to do is to let industry and others just come forward to scale it up. We should have 10,000, 20,000 students going into these industries. For example, Coimbatore Industry Association has already come forward. They're supporting 200 students. This is much more than we do. There is also issue of supporting innovation. Last point I'll make a stop here actually is that some problem that we start from home. Nobody talks about this. Problem that we don't allow our children to work with hand. So they have developed a bias against working with hand. This flows into school. They don't work in the labs. They don't like to work in engineering labs. If they become engineer, they don't want to stick to engineering. This is because we create a gap between mind and hand. This needs to break. Thank you very much.